What's up, everyone? It's Ed from Bar Stars. A lot of you guys been asking about shoulder workouts, so today I'll be showing you some shoulder workouts along with the muscle actions involved with your shoulder, so you're able to understand the exercises. All right, so your shoulder muscle is called the deltoid. It's made up of three heads: the anterior head, which is over here, the lateral head, which is the side, and posterior deltoid, which is the back of your shoulder. Each head is responsible for a different type of movement. So a lot of pushing movements, for example, push-ups, are involving the anterior deltoid. Lateral movements, as far as bringing your arms up, are the lateral deltoid. And then a lot of pulling exercises, or your arms retracting back, is the posterior deltoid. Now I'll be showing you different exercises. All right, as explained earlier, the anterior deltoid is involved in a lot of pushing movements. So a lot of people generally work it out already through push-ups and a lot of the popular movements. If you feel like you still need more work for your anterior deltoid, you can do push-ups on your bench, which I'll be showing you now. Make sure to get all your pressure and weight lean forward onto the push-ups. All right, now I'll be showing you the pike push-up. I'm using a dip bar for assistance. You put your feet up and make sure your body turns into an angle and then push up like that. All right, once you master the pike push-up, the next step is the handstand push-up. Now, if it's your first time trying it, have someone there to spot you to make sure you don't get hurt. Although, it's very rarely I've seen someone get hurt. So what you're trying to do is keep your hands shoulder width apart, kick your legs up to a supporting object. For this, I'll be using the bar. You can use the gate, a wall, etc. Or even your partner's hands. Then come down and back up. All right, there's a light workout to work out your lateral delts. So what you do is you start a diamond at the bottom, open your hands up, come over and do a diamond at the top. Now I know you're gonna say it's easy. You have to do many reps. So I'll say around 30 to 40 reps. And remember, it's a controlled movement. It's not this. It's one, two, three, trust me, I would like to see you comment below after you do 30 or 40 and let me know how you feel. Good exercise for your lateral delts and also the rotator cuff muscles. Keep your arms straight out and causing small circles. Controlled circles, so you're not wobbling your arms like this, but controlled circles. Now I do this for time. I would say 30 seconds forward, 30 seconds backwards, and then 30 seconds hold. And as you get stronger, move on to higher numbers. So for example, from sideways, and then hold. Okay, and a good exercise for your rear delts is inverted bodyweight rows. So what you wanna do is keep your feet elevated, lean back, come up, squeeze your shoulders, come back down. So here we go, for example. Another good way to work out your shoulders is when you're doing dips, lean in. And then once you get more advanced, you can do tuck planche push-ups. And that really focuses on your shoulder. So I'll give you examples of both. So here's the lean in dip. Now here's the tuck planche push-up. All right, I hope you enjoyed the exercises. Try them out. Now for the harder exercises, keep a lower rep range, and the easier exercises, keep a higher rep range. Of course, you have to really focus on the shoulder muscle as you're doing certain exercises. For example, if you're doing 50 push-ups, yes, it's a workout that involves your shoulder, but if you're not focusing your energy into your shoulder, then your triceps and your chest and other muscles will be picking up the work instead of your shoulders. So when you're working out your shoulders, make sure to mentally think of the contractions going on in your shoulders. All right, comment below, like and share, and let us know what the next video should be. Peace.